And away we go. Caesars William Hill releasing its NBA win totals right here on Daily Wager. There are the numbers of a 72-game schedule. Bucks for the second straight year of the highest win total. This one's 51.5. The defending champs, 47. It's always important to read that fine print. We've obviously learned that here in 2020. Got to play at least 70 games for those tickets to be valid. LeBron, since being drafted in 2003, straight out of high school, he has had the highest or co-highest win total in their respective conference in 10 of 18 possible seasons. Think about that. His team, dating back to when he was a rookie, 10 of 18. Certainly remarkable. Obviously, the most of any player over that span. Bring back Joe. Bring in Preston Johnson. All right, Preston, what do you make of this Lakers over-under at 47?
It's too high. Let's start with the fact that LeBron James wanted this season to start at least a month from when it's supposed to start. There's rumors flying around that he may take a few weeks off to start the season. Either way, I think at the very least, they'll be proactive in resting him, going the load management route frequently throughout the season. The other thing that I dislike is the fact that they traded away Danny Green for Dennis Schroeder, a guy that I think can get picked on defensively. And for whatever reason, people seem to undervalue Danny Green, a guy who won championships with the Spurs. He wins another one with the Raptors. Then he wins one with the Lakers. I'm like, all right, see you later, man. Thanks. Look, he had the highest net rating of any Laker in the playoffs. If you want to say it's because he's on the floor with LeBron and AD, look at the Lakers' individual net ratings when guys are off the floor then. There were three where the Lakers were a net negative. LeBron, AD, and Danny Green. That means that when Danny Green was off the court and LeBron and AD were still playing, the Lakers were still a net negative. His impact, I don't think they'll be able to overcome it with a mid-level exception, on top of the fact that the Pacific Division with the Suns, the Clippers, even the Warriors, despite the Clay unfortunate injury there in his Achilles, they're all better. They're all improved. Blazers still. Mavericks making moves. So I just think they're not going to be able to duplicate that regular season success again.
All right, and I'm right there with you. We're fellow Laker fans. Betting the under, that's my favorite play because of what you touched on. Normal turnaround from the last NBA Finals game to the first regular season game is about 4+ months. This is 2+ months, and they are openly saying, as Preston alluded to, that they might just be load management of the year. Now, go back to the beginning of last season. Remember, LeBron finally missed the playoffs, didn't go deep into it. They were ready from the start. New coach, new Anthony Davis, all that needed to set the tone, see what they had, and work through the growing pains. Now they don't have to, assuming AD back. Yes, they lost Danny Green, but for the most part, they know what they are, and they didn't need home court last year. LeBron's always been sort of indifferent to a home court advantage, so I think they're going to pace themselves, and I think in 2020, when you're talking about sports, and there's no bubble here, right, like last year, like last season, there's going to be COVID issues and things like that. We've learned that with football. We've learned that with baseball, so you kind of have to lean under with all these teams with high numbers, so I'm going to go under.
We're talking about 48 wins here to cash the over. Give me the why the Lakers would want to get the 48 wins. I know why the Sixers and the Celtics and the Bucks would want to get the 48 wins. Why do the Lakers need to get the 48 wins? Are the Clippers going to be a threat this year? You need home court over them? That was all hat, no cattle. Fun story
last
year.
They're in the same arena.
Yeah, exactly. So there's no issue with that. The Warriors just lost Klay Thompson. What's the rush in the Western Conference to get yourself a one seed or a two seed? You just got to get into the playoffs with your Lakers. You're fine. We're talking about winning 66% of your games in order to go over. You get an average of about 4.5 teams per year that pull that off. I don't see them being one because I don't think they want to be one. That's not their plan. Their plan is to be ready for the playoffs.
Yeah, and you mentioned what Preston touched on, the Pacific Division, the games where they had more games against got better. Phoenix is improved, and the Warriors figure to be better.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.